believe in me because I'm your creator and I'm the omniscient creator.
Yes. What about you, Muhammad?
I agree with Rahman, yeah. Mm-hmm. And the fact that this ayah specifies that Allah Ta'ala, He created so many species on this earth and everything on this earth and the sky. And I'm just one of them. We are just, mankind is just one of them. And He created all of this for us. Okay? Tells us that there is a big purpose of us being here. Mm-hmm. Allah Ta'ala creating us. And then obviously the ayah also says about Allah having all the knowledge because He is the creator.
So basically what you get out of it is more about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah. Do you get any scientific aspects of the ayah?
Yes. I see that he has fashioned the earth, okay, specially. And I see that is slightly in the whole universe. You see that the earth is different from everything, and our life is different from everything.
Yes.
And we are at a balance, you know, at a very specific balance.
Yes.
And that I see that he has mentioned that he has taken pain and he has done this specially.
Yes. Abdul Rahman, the unseen parts of the science in the earth and the sky. How when you listen to the ayah, what do you really imagine?
Well, the ayah tells me basically about the sequence of creation. Allah has started with creating the earth, and then He turned to the sky for something I don't know, maybe Dr. Zaghloul will...
This is a very important point that we will have to return to Professor Zaghloul at the beginning, the sequence.
Yes.
This is a very important point.
You see, this verse actually was misinterpreted by some of the commentators. Some would say, does this mean that the earth was created before the firmament for the sky?
Yes.
Actually, the creation took place in one go. Because we know with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His word be and it will be. So even scientifically, we can see today that the process of creation of the heavens and earth happened simultaneously at exactly the same time. Because none of these two entities could be separated from the other.
Yes, and time is not an element into the creation.
No, the time, of course, we as human beings, we are controlled by time.
Yes.
But Allah is above time and above space, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And neither time nor space can delimit the identity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yes.
So He can order things be and it will be. And the beauty in the verse, it emphasizes the fact of creation. As Abu Rahman said, it emphasizes the fact of creation. Because at the beginning of this century, or even earlier, since the days of Renaissance, science developed in the West by a challenge between the church and the scientists. And scientists were persecuted quite a lot. And finally, science emerged as the giant in the West. And science started by a complete divorce with religion, complete divorce with the church and with religion at large.
And I think it's an ongoing fight. But until now, you find aspects of science that a lot of scholars, religious scholars, would think it's against religion.
No, but you see, it's the tailoring of the scientific notions by atheists or agnostics. They gave it the flavor of not believing.
Yes.
You see, but really, scientific achievements at the climax of today are supporting every single scientific notion in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So at the very beginning, you could see negation, complete negation of creation. They say this universe is eternal, and they produce what they call the steady state theory.
Yes.
That the universe is eternal; it had no beginning, will never have an end. And nowadays, scientists try to assess at what time the universe was created. And they are giving calculations. And they believe that the universe was created around 13.5 billion years ago.
Yes.
And when the earth was created, when the moon was created. And we believe that this took place in one go. So if you read the, a classic book in geology or in astronomy, they used to have the slogan, there is no vestige of a beginning nor sign for an end. Now they are trying to calculate the beginning and also trying to calculate when the end will be. So when the Quran speaks about creation, you see, these latest scientific discoveries substantiate the fact that this universe is not eternal. It had a beginning. And everything with a beginning must have an end. So this testifies to the fact that the universe and everything that's in it was physically created. Yes. Secondly, the Quran differentiates between the early creation of the heavens and the earth and the later differentiation of the earth, the one earth, into seven earths, and the differentiation of the one firmament into seven firmaments. Yes. And that's why this verse, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. It is He, Allah, the Lord of that universe, who has created for you everything on that earth, you see. ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَسَوَّهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ. After the creation, then He started the differentiation. He made the earth into seven earths and made the sky into seven skies. And verse ends by saying that وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. And Allah is knowledgeable of everything. Yani, this is His work, His creation. He knows everything, you see. And that's why the beauty here is the emphasis on the fact that everything was created, that everything must have a creator. This creator has to be above His creation. Neither matter nor energy can shape His identity. Neither space nor time can delimit that identity. And this is what we can get out from this beautiful cosmic verse in the Quran.
Okay, Professor Zaghloul, we'll take a very short break and return back to explain further into this ayah. So stay tuned.